Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel Base Mechanical Engineering. In this video, I explain you impact of jet on a moving cow plate striking one end of the tip tangentially. Means this part is known as a tip and the water is strike tangentially, and I show you the one by one lines how to draw its velocity diagrams, and I give you guarantee if you watch this video then you are able to draw any velocity triangles for a turbine or either a pump or an impact of jet. In this video, I explain you the velocity triangles for inlet and outlet for a three different cases when the alpha 2 is less than 90, equal to 90 and greater than 90. Then I explain you how to find out the work done and efficiency. Now, first, that is a case for a moving plate or a cow plate. So first we draw the cow plates. Then one draw the central line and we draw the blade angle, that is a beta 1 and beta 2. This is the inlet part, so inlet part is denoted as the 1 and outlet part is denoted as a 2. So for inlet we use the 1 notations and for outlet we use the 2 notations. And what is the beta 1 and beta 2? So beta 1 is angle between the relative velocity VR1 and direction of motion of a blade. Means relative velocity is also come on these lines, and this is known as a blade angle at the inlet. Means this is a blade or a plate and its angle, it is known as the beta 1, and this part is known as the angle of deflection phi. Phi is equal to 180 minus in bracket beta 1 minus beta 2. Now the water is strike at tangentially. Tangentially means water jet is come contact with the one point of a plate, it is known as tangentially. And this water, it strike with the velocity V1, and V1 means it is the velocity of the jet at the inlet. When the water is strike, the plate is start to move with the velocity U in a X direction, not in the direction of jet, but plate is move in a this horizontal directions. The water strike with the velocity V1 and its angle is alpha 1, means the nozzle is inclined at an angle of alpha 1. So alpha 1 is angle between the direction of jet, means this is the direction of jet, and to the motion of the blade. Blade motion is in X directions. So we draw the one line here, and this angle is known as the alpha 1, or it is also known as the guide blade angle. And its line is represented as a line A to B. Now when the any velocity as an incline, then it is divided in a two parts. The first part it's the horizontals and second part it's the vertical. So what we do, we draw the one horizontal line from a point A, means this line, and this horizontal line or a component of V1 in a horizontal direction is known as the velocity of wall. V means velocity, W means wall, and for inlet we indicate the 1. So what is the VW1? It is the component of velocity of the jet V1 in a horizontal direction. By mistake it is written here the vertical, but it is in horizontal directions. Okay, so and W means it is a velocity of wall, and this velocity of wall is denoted as a line A to D, and vertical part of the V1, it is a line B to D. So we draw the one vertical line from the here, it is a line BD, and this vertical part of a V1 is known as the velocity of flow, and it is denoted as a VF1, and VF1 means the component of the velocity of the jet V1 in a vertical directions. So horizontal part is VW1, vertical part is VF1. W means wall velocity, F means flow velocity. Now in this velocity triangle we indicate another two parameters, that is the relative velocity VR1 and the velocity of the blade U1. So in the earlier case we learned that the relative velocity is drawn on this blade angle line, that is a beta 1. Relative velocity means velocity of a jet and the velocity of a blade. So when the water is coming with absolute velocity V1 but blade is moving with velocity U, so water is strike at the relative velocity. Okay, relative velocity means when you sit on this blade and you see the velocity of the jet, it is known as the relative velocity. Okay, So Z and blade is moving in the same direction, so it is a relative velocity is difference between the V1 minus U1. Okay, so this blue line is indicated as the relative velocity line VR1, and we indicate this line as a, and its angle is beta 1, that is already mentioned here, so it is a beta 1, and relative velocity line is B2C, and VR1 means relative velocity of jet at inlet. Now next we indicate the U1 terms. So which one is the U1, A2C or a C2D? So for that we write the equation of relative velocity, that is a V1 minus U1, that is all we already we learned. So this is the line of V1 and point 1, and this is the line of VR1. Okay, so this is one point and this is one point. Thus, this A to C line is indicated as the velocity of the blade U1, means blade velocity at the inlet. So by using this equation, you draw the one line that is horizontal between the V1 and VR1. It is known as the velocity of the blades. Okay, and this U1 is equal to velocity of blade at inlets. So here we complete our inlet velocity triangles. Next we move towards the outlet velocity triangles. Before that, I request you to subscribe my channels, share with your friends, like and comment. Your like is give us the motivations to make the more video. Now we are considering this surface of a curved plate is too smooth. That means the relative velocity VR1 is equal to relative velocity VR2. Okay, so here similarly on the blade angle line beta 2, relative velocity is coming, but before that we draw the absolute velocity of a jet at outlet. So this similar term is used, but instance of this one we return the 2, and instance of inlet we return the outlets. So velocity v2 is coming at an angle of alpha 2. In inlet we use the angle alpha 1 for the V1 velocity, that is absolute velocity of jet. Here we use the angle alpha 2. On this similar case, we divide this velocity, absolute velocity V2 in a two parts. One is horizontals, second one is the vertical. This horizontal part is known as a VW2, that is velocity of wall at outlet. V means velocity, W means wall. This vertical part, it is known as the VF2. So VF2 is the component of V2 in a vertical direction, and it is denoted as the VF2, that means velocity of a flow. Now next we draw the relative velocity line VR2. So we know that it is come on the blade angle beta 2. So this part of a light blue line, it is indicated as a VR2, and its angle with the x-axis, that is the beta 2. Now similarly we return the relative velocity equation for the outlet. VR2 is equal to V2 minus U2. So this is the line of V2 and this is the line of VR2. So we connect this line and it gives us the velocity of the blade U2. So this part is known as the velocity of the blade at the outlet U2, and we give its notation, that is a PQRS. So it's just a simple to draw the velocity triangles. Next we find out the equations of a force, then after work done, and efficiency. So again we use these velocity triangles for finding out the equation of force. So force exerted by a jet in direction of motion, this is the direction of motion is x, so we indicate as the force fx, and we applying the Newton's second law, that is a mass into initial relative velocity of a jet in direction of blade motion minus final relative velocity of the jet. So in a mass we are considering the relative velocity, the mass coming with the velocity v1, but it strike with the relative velocity. So here mass we consider as a rho a in bracket v1 minus u1. Initial relative velocity is the v1 minus u1, and final velocity in a x direction is zero. Sorry, not it's zero, but it is at the this line. Okay, so we considering this relative velocity component in x directions. So this VR1, here we apply the equation of cos beta 1, then we get this horizontal component, that is a CD. CD is equal to VR1 cos beta 1 minus, again we use the minus term because the relative velocity in this case is from left to right. but in outlet it is right to left. So when the direction is changed, we indicate in a negatives. If you are not understand this term in a equation of cos beta 1, so this equation is not necessary. We write the another equation directly from velocity triangles. That is a rho a vr1 in bracket vw1 minus u1. Means we considering the component of relative velocity in x direction, because the blade is moving in a x direction. This component is cd. So cd is equal to vw1 minus u1. So here we write down minus the relative velocity component in a x direction, that is u2 plus vw2. But we consider it's negative because it is in opposite direction as the inlets. Now this u1 and u2 is same, so it's a cancels, and we get the equation is that the rho a vr1 in bracket vw1 plus vw2. Okay, this u1 and u2 one time plus and one time minus, and it is a equal, u1 is equal to u2, so this term is cancels. Now this is the final equations for the fx, and we consider this equation is right only when this alpha 2 is equal to less than 90. Okay, this equation is right only when the alpha 2 is less than 90. Now if alpha 2 is greater than 90, if alpha 2 is 90, then how to find out the equation of force? So first we take that if alpha 2 is greater than 90, then what we need to change in this equation? This line is moving toward these lines, means we draw another velocity triangle. This is a v2 and this angle is alpha 2. So here we measure this alpha, this angle is greater than 90. Then we divide in two component, horizontals, verticals, relative velocity line is as it is at the angle alpha 2. Okay, so at that time what happened? So here instance of the minus, this minus, it is come plus, because in this inlet it is moved from left to right and it is also in the outlet left to right. So this minus is cancelled. Then what happened? We get the vw1 minus vw2. So this fx equation for a alpha 2 is greater than 90, that rho a vr1 in bracket vw1 minus vw2. That means instance of plus we get only the minus. Now in second case, alpha 2 is equal to 90. Alpha 2 is equal to 90, then what happened? This v2 line is come as the same line as the vf2. When we are doing this, moving this v2 line in a straight, means it's come as a, this green line, then what happened? This line is moving from here to vertical, then vw2 is equal to 0. In this case, when we moving this v2 line and try to make verticals, then what happened? This vw2 part is 0. That means line itself vertical, then horizontal part vw2 is equal to 0. So v2 is equal to vf2, vw2 is equal to 0, relative velocity has same line, u2. So what happened? Vw2 is 0. So what is the equation for fx? It is a rho a vr1 into vw1. Okay, now so from these three cases we try to write down the one common equation. Fx is equal to rho a vr1 in bracket vw1 plus 1 minus vw2. So this is the common equation for all these three cases. When we take plus, when alpha 2 is less than 90, when alpha 2 is greater than 90, then we consider as a minus, and alpha 2 equal to 90, then we consider is equal to the vw2 is equal to the 0. Now we find out the work done and efficiency. Before that, I request you to subscribe my channel, share with your friends, comment on the video if you learn something. Now next we find out this work done. Work done is equal to force into distance travel. That is, the work done is equal to force into distance travel per second. In this case, distance is not given, velocity is given. So when we multiply the force with velocity, we get the power. But in all the book, it is the written as the work done. So we call this is not work done, but rate of work done, or it is a power. So fx equation we already derived, that is a rho a vr1 in bracket vw1 plus 1 minus vw2 into u. So this is the equation of work done, and power develop p, it's again as written as same equations, because in this case instance of distance we consider the velocity, and the power unit is joule per seconds. Next we derive the blade efficiency. The efficiency is equal to output upon input. Output is the power developed, input is the kinetic energy supplied to the water jet. So kinetic energy equation is written 1 by 2 m v1 squares. So what is the value of m in this case? That is a rho a v1, because velocity, water coming out we have V1 velocity from the nozzles and we are finding out the kinetic energy at the nozzle. So this mass is not a rho A VR1, but this mass is equal to rho A V1 because we are finding out the mass coming out from a nozzle, not striking. So rho A V1 into V1 square, so it is converted into the V1 cubes. Output energy equation is same. Then rho A VR1, then we get this final equations for a blade velocity. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like my video, subscribe my channels and share with your friends.